Podcast Live, you're on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And this morning, we're discussing why it's so important to support children's natural curiosity and all their why questions. Of course, we have Nikki Bush, our resident human potential and parenting expert. Nikki, as always, so good to be able to connect with you this morning. How are you?
I'm well, thank you, Jamie.
Let's get straight into it. Because our children ask every single question there is out there. Why do our children ask all these questions?
Children are so naturally curious and inquisitive that what if and I wonder are driving forces of exploration and discovery in childhood, as well as in the future world of work. So actually, our children being curious is something as parents we need to keep that mindset alive forever, because it's going to serve them in their future. So this is one of our key tasks. So they want to know, how does the world work? They're intrigued, they're puzzled, they're provoked, and they have this sense of wonder about the world. And that's something that we need to take on as parents. We've been around for long enough to feel jaded about the world, but children just kind of appear and go, oh, why do the waves crash on the beach? Why is the sky blue? What will happen if I grab the dog's tail? And the key to raising a smarter child is to help them to actually ask good questions, and preferably to help them find as many answers for themselves by themselves, because they are explorers seeking explanations about the world around them.
I'm definitely in that phase with my toddler now. Luca's approaching the 3-year-old benchmark, and all he does is ask me questions. Mom, why is this? And sometimes I don't have the answers. And then I would actually ask him the questions. I'm like, so why do you think the ocean is blue? Or why do you think the sun is yellow? But should we be answering all of our children's questions? Because sometimes we don't know the answers.
Look, sometimes we don't know the answers. And then you can say to your child, I'm not sure what the answer is. Let's find out together. And then you go on this journey of exploration together. But very often what happens, Jamie, is that those why questions often come in the car or while you're multitasking doing something else. And to get your child off your back, you tend to just glibly give them the answers instead of doing the step back and saying, but what do you think? And sometimes we need to ask our children, so what do you think? I don't know. And get them to start asking themselves those questions instead of defaulting to a mini lecture, which can often shut down a child. Mm. So helping them discover answers for themselves is the basis of inquiry-based education. And some of the more modern schools are starting to recalibrate their curriculum so that children, their sense of curiosity is what actually drives the lessons. So we need to respond with, I don't know, what do you think? Or what do you think the answer is? Or that Socratic questioning. For every question they give you, ask a question back so that we get to deeper and deeper levels of inquiry. Of course you can't do that all the time. Of course you have to answer some of your children's questions straight off the bat, and some of them are urgent and they need an answer right now. But when you've got the time, play a little with their curiosity. Make them think a little.
Nikki, and then in your words, how can we then help our children discover answers for themselves so we are not answering everything for them?
Well, I think that this also starts with making sure we don't keep our children too busy in adult-directed activities. And because parents are busy today, we tend to put children in activities all afternoon, and they have very little time for daydreaming, for getting bored. And actually, boredom and daydreaming are at the heart of curiosity, because when children are bored, they look for solutions to their boredom. We tend to just hand them a screen with an app and they get into playing a game instead of creating fun out of nothing. So allowing their mind to wander is a really good thing. And if you think about what is happening in large organizations today, the product developers, the CEOs are actually taking time out, getting away from the rat race of being kind of scheduled all the time and putting themselves in environments where they can daydream. And they say this is where their best ideas come from. In fact, ideas come in the bath or the shower. They come while you're lying in bed and often while you're driving somewhere, because your mind is actually off the topic that you're obsessing over, and it is wondering. And this is when the brain, which is much cleverer than you and I, actually connects the dots by itself. And that's what we need to give our children space to do.
So many pearls of wisdom coming through this morning. But of course, we are going to be continuing our conversation with Nikki in just a bit. So stay with us. It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. We are back here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show with parenting expert and human potential expert Nikki Bush to answer questions into why our children are so curious. Of course, Nikki, you're still with us this morning. You good?
I'm good. Thank you, Jamie.
Thank you so much for staying with us. Back to it, okay? How should we answer our children's questions to keep their sense of curiosity alive?
Well, the first thing is don't answer all of their questions straight off the bat. It's so tempting when we're tired, when we're busy, while we're multitasking, our child asks us a question and we just glibly give them an answer. And when we do that, what we're often doing is shutting down their curiosity because we're not getting back to them and asking them what they think. And their thoughts are very important. Their sense of inquiry and curiosity needs to be respected and celebrated. So let's make sure that we actually get into an engaging serve and return type conversation with our children sometimes around their questions. And that means conversation, connection, actually underlies curiosity with children. So engaging conversation, make it safe for your children to share their thoughts, their ideas, and their questions. There's no such thing as a stupid question. And our children need to learn that because in the world of work, people who ask really good questions go far.
I love that. And then obviously you said there's times where they would ask it in the car, in the bath. Is there then a space and a place for daydreaming?
Oh, absolutely. You know, we tend to keep our children so busy that they have no time to get bored. For some reason, parents think that bored children is a bad thing, but actually boredom is at the heart of creativity and curiosity, because that's when people start asking questions like, why not? Perhaps, maybe, what if? And in fact, if you think about all great inventions, all new things start with that question, why or why not? And that's what we need our children to be asking all the time, is maybe this can be done a different way. Why can't we do it this way? Can we maybe have tomato sauce on our cornflakes? And of course, the first answer that's going to come up from a parent is, of course not. You don't have tomato sauce with cornflakes. But you know what? You can have tomato sauce with mealies. And maybe you do need to allow your children to experiment and with their curiosity and try different things.
And who knows, maybe that is a new recipe, cornflakes with tomato sauce. We might try it in the kitchen. It might be a winner. But here's my question, Nikki. Can too much adult direction really dampen a child's curiosity and the need to ask why?
Definitely. Because if we're always stepping in with an answer, there's no reason to ask another question of, but why? But why? And I know we get tired and frustrated with all these why questions, especially between the ages of 3 and 7, when children are mastering language and starting to connect the dots. They do ask a lot of questions, and it is exhausting being a parent. But just know that this is an illustration of your child's curiosity and inquisitiveness and thirst for learning. And let's take this one step further. As they get older and they get onto social media, we also need them to develop this curiosity as an attitude, because they're going to be exposed to fake news and the echo chamber of the world just giving them the same old, same old. So we want a child who's actually going to question the status quo. So please celebrate that your child's curiosity is important and is going to set him or her up well for the future and a fast-changing future. So I really do say that their curiosity must always be stronger than their fear.
Love that. Again, a question I have for you. Why do you think curiosity is such an essential attitude and also trait to develop for a fast-changing world in the world that we're living in right now?
Jamie, we need original thought to create original solutions for big problems that we haven't yet solved on the planet yet. You just have to think about climate change as being our next big issue that we're all focusing on. And we really need kids growing up, entering the world of work with fresh new thinking. If you think of someone like Elon Musk, he has challenged the status quo in terms of electric vehicles, the longevity of battery life. Breaking through new frontiers always starts with a why question. So we want to celebrate children and encourage children to keep asking why.
Nikki, why is this segment so short? We could speak with you the entire day, but thank you so much for joining us this morning. As always, pearls of wisdom. And now we don't have to say no anymore, but rather not, and think of a different way to approaching those answers when it comes to our kids. So thank you so much.
Great pleasure, Jamie.
Once again, that was Nikki Bush, human potential and parenting expert. Of course, for our viewers at home, you can get hold of more of this content from Nikki's book, Future Proof Your Child for the 2020s and Beyond, from good bookstores or from www.nikkibush.com.